यहाँ उपस्थित सभी को मेरा नमस्कार। मैं आप सबका चौथे भारतीय विज्ञान सम्मेलन में कुछ ही देर में उद्घाटन समारोह की शुरुआत होगी। जैसे कि आप सब जानते हैं, भारतीय विज्ञान सम्मेलन गोवा में पहली बार हो रहा है और यही फुटबॉल ग्राउंड पर बहुत बड़ा एक्सपो आयोजित किया गया है। एक्सपो का उद्घाटन कल गोवा के माननीय राज्यपाल श्रीमती मृदुला सिन्हा के हाथों हुआ। इस उद्घाटन के लिए भारत के माननीय रक्षा मंत्री श्री मनोहर जी पर्रिकर भी उपस्थित थे। इट इज अ मैटर ऑफ ग्रेट एंड साइंटिस्ट ऑफ इंडिया। पद्म विभूषण डॉक्टर अनिल काकोडकर डज नॉट रिक्वायर एन इंट्रोडक्शन। ही इज अ वेल नोन इंडियन न्यूक्लियर साइंटिस्ट। एंड डॉक्टर विजय भटकर डिस्टिंग्विश्ड एज द आर्किटेक्ट ऑफ सुपर कंप्यूटर हु विल ऑल्सो ग्रेस द ओकेजन। दे आर द टू एमिनेंट साइंटिस्ट ऑफ इंडिया हु हैव बीन प्रूव्ड अ मेटल टू आवर कंट्री। दे आर हियर टू शेयर देयर नॉलेज विद अस। They have accepted a lot of challenges and proved that India produces the best scientists in the world. I am also greatly honored to have with us other eminent dignitaries from different fields for the program. भारत का ज्ञान
भारत से आए हुए मेरे देशवासियों, आपका इस अवसर पर स्वागत है। इट इज इंडीड एन इंडिकेटर ऑफ नेशनल इंटीग्रेशन दैट वी हैव पीपल राइट फ्रॉम जम्मू टू कन्याकुमारी, कश्मीर टू कन्याकुमारी, एंड देन फ्रॉम गुजरात टू अरुणाचल प्रदेश, ऑल आर हियर टुडे and have joined us. So this is my welcome. As a formal welcome, I welcome our chief guest today, Padma Vibhushan, Dr. Anil Kakodkar, who is known to this country and the world over as an expert in the field of nuclear science. He has his roots here, and so every time the name comes up, we are proud of him. We have amongst us Padma Bhushan, Dr. Vijay Bhatkar, our national president of Vijnan Bharati, who is known as the father of Param Computer, and he is amongst us. I welcome him. Sri Kevan Kumar Sharma, who is representing the government of Goa today here, the chief secretary of Goa, well-known and a very competent administrator who has proved his mettle all over the country for years. He is amongst us today. I welcome him. Dr. Satish Shetye, our Vice Chancellor, who has the credit that the long awaited A grade to Goa University, he has achieved and brought it to Goa. And we are proud of him. He is our Chairman of Organizing Committee for Bharatiya Vijnan Sammelan. I welcome you, sir. Sri Jay Kumar, the National Secretary, has been with us all the while. He has been guiding us, and I welcome you, sir, here. Sri Jayantra Saraswati, who is our Organizing Secretary of Vijnan Bharati, another relentless worker, is amongst us. I welcome you, sir. Harilal Ji Menon, professor from Goa University, but more important to us as the organizing secretary of Vijnan Parishad. Welcome you, sir, here. In the audience, there are many dignitaries, but I should have taken somebody's name first, but due to certain reasons, I have to take it now. Our Honorable Chief Minister, Sri Lakshmikant Parsekar, is amongst us. And He has really honored us by his presence here. I welcome you, sir. Dr. Manmohanji Vaidya is amongst us. He has traveled all the way for us. And then so many more dignitaries here who have come from all over the country. I welcome you all here. And I'm sure this day will be quite remarkable. And the following 2 days of our Bhartiya Vidyan Sammelan will be remembered. Bhartiya Vidyan Sammelan, as we all know, is something of a unique activity. It's a festival of people's movement for science. India has the science in its philosophy right from beginning. And we will be showcasing it in this 3 days of deliberations. Yesterday we already had the inauguration of Expo. Many of you may have already attended that. And those who have not done it, those who have come today only, I request you to give your adequate time even to the visit for that. I welcome again everybody who is here and namaste to you. Declared open. The most respected Chief Minister, Government of Goa, our mentor, Sri Dr. Manmohan Vaidya Ji, advisor to Vigyan Bharati, Sri Dr. Chandra Tatwadi, our patron, Dr. Anand Karkodkar Ji, National President of Vigyan Bharati, Dr. Dev Bhatkar, Chief Secretary of Goa, Sri K.K. Sharma Ji, National Organizing Secretary of Vigyan Bharati, Sri Jayanti Sahasrabuddhe, State President of Vigyan Bharati Goa, Subhash Ji Goa. This is the fourth edition of Bharati Vigyan Sangar. Three Bharati Vigyan Sangars has happened in last 7 years. We have started this conference in 2007 at Bhopal. Why Vigyan Bharati has started such a sammelan? In India, We have several scientific conferences, seminars, workshops. You know that most of you have participated in many of such events. This is the brainchild of Professor K. Vasu, who has founded this movement in 1982 at Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore. Never ever in India a scientific conference people in all walks of life can walk in, come in and attend, present paper, and their emotions, their theories, their intellectual innovations. It is not possible in this country because of language, because of certain limitations which limits the people to enter into these conferences. And we set up a range there, scientific conferences as a separate decorum. Actually, Bharatiya Vigyan Sammelan tries to break this decorum, that our farmers can come, artisans can come, even students and school students and college students can come. Anybody who has a fire and who has a scientific temper in their mind, they can come and present, they can participate, their ideas can be exchanged with the scientific community. Any language, they can present the papers in any language, in Sanskrit or in Hindi or in regional language, any regional languages. And it is giving immense thrust to the traditional knowledge, traditional sciences and technology. So Vigyan Bharati has started this Bharati Vigyan Sangam. Like that, Vigyan Bharati has innovated many such programs, many such projects in this country. Some decades ago, science means to get the materialistic outcome, materialistic benefit to the humanity. That is, we need science, and the application of science, the technology we needed. So in that, some 3-4 decades before, this was arise in different parts of the country. Scientific community has taken that science is for the materialistic benefit of the humanity. But we know that Bharat is a different nation. It is a Deva Bhumi. Its concepts and philosophy is entirely different. So some few scientists in the Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore, they came together. They started a movement called as the Swadeshi Movement for the Science. In November 7, C.V. Raman's birthday in 1982, they came together and they called it as the C.V. Raman's birthday, the Swadeshi Day, Swadeshi Science Day. And they celebrated November 7th, bringing together different scientific community, people, some common people, and they have discussed, they have given lectures. So science means not only the materialistic, it is a science and spirituality should go to the end. That is one of the basic philosophy we have put forward. Now the entire world has accepted, recognized that science cannot be dealing with spirituality, it can go hand in hand. Second thing is, science means international. We also told, even now there are confusion there. How a Swadeshi science movement can come up? It is a utter nonsense where science coming into a certain barrier, certain, you know what, in the country, in the nationalizing. Not like that. Science is international, we are accepting that. But there are certain sciences that develop in India,
with its own philosophical basis. That one is Ayurveda. Ayurveda cannot be defined in the modern allopathy, the Western paradigm. Its basic tenets are different. So it is a Swadeshi science, we call it. Yoga Shastra Padati. It cannot be explained in the Western concept. It has its own Indianness in that. So yoga is called as a Swadeshi science. There are many environmental philosophies, ideas, concepts developed in this country. We have meditation, never accepted some 40-50 years ago in the world. Now the meditation is one of the top ranked science which we can take into masses. The people can, even the students can meditate and make their energy, make their thought process more bigger. So these type of Swadeshi sciences developed in the country. So we are a movement to propagate a Swadeshi sciences also. Second, another point is, we are international. We have to develop science and technology at the international package. People know. We have to first cater the 1.2 billion people in this country. We are a nationalist scientific movement. We are a patriotic science movement. We never have any sense of shame to say our first and foremost importance is India and our Bharat. So it becomes a patriotic science movement. Whatever the other people say that they are limited to certain countries, no. One Swami Vivekananda's history teacher told that. Swami Vivekananda himself too. If some of my friend could not treat his mother properly, how I can think my friend will look after my mother when my mother is in ill or some issues. So we have to be a self-reliant nation with all the capabilities. We need, our nation should be developed with the need of our country. Even now we have 6.75 lakh villages. 6,75,000 villages we have. We have never several issues there. So these issues are the most important for a science movement in the country. So our there are many research organizations can happen in the country. So how this research organization should do? What is the line of research orientation in this country? It should oriented to the common masses of this country. Our research should have a reorientation. Our scientific R&D institutions have to look into the needs of the country, because our country, the Lesser Planning Commission report is telling them nearly 20 crore in this country doesn't have access to electricity. 20 crore people in this country. Nearly 1,20,000 villages doesn't have a primary health center. Nearly 1,25,000 villages doesn't have a primary education. So if you look into these things, in India for drinking water, a woman has to travel 10,000 kilometers in their life to get drinking water. So several such issues are there. So our movement, Vigyan Bharati, is a movement for the common masses, linking the policies with the grassroots level people. Many things we are telling them, we have to learn many things from the labs. We are telling that we have to learn many things from the land. We have to take the fields to the lab rather than from the lab to the fields. Yesterday, the one of the most important research institutions, INGOIS, one of the senior scientists is telling, now we are predicting the many ocean fishermen issues. By knowing their traditional knowledge, we are taking it and researching on that, and then we are giving the same information to the across the world about the ocean problems and what are happening there, the waves and everything, wind and everything. The traditional knowledge from the fisherman community, a research organization is taking it and giving the information to the masses. So we have to learn many things from this field. We should not say these are all traditional knowledge, these are bogus. They have no scientific basis. No? So we are an organization which have a very proud belief that India's contribution to the world of science is immense. India has contributed immense knowledge to the world. Never happened till now. No textbooks are revealing about the Indian achievements in the world of science. Aryabhatta, never known about the Aryabhatta. Nagarjuna, Charaka, Sushruta, Bharadwaja. Who knows these scientists? So Vijnan Bharati is a movement to highlight the achievements and innovations made by these traditional sages and sannyasis to the world of science. So in that way, we are linking with the tradition, with the modernity. Not only the traditional knowledge, the most modern knowledge, how this can be blended with the traditional knowledge, and we are taking them to the masses. So such a movement is happening. We have 33 units across the country. We have 12 streams we have made. The first ever waste management institute we have started in Bhopal. We have a women wings at Shakti we have for the empowering women through the intervention of science and technology. We have a young students movement, we have young scientists forum we have. We have how the technology and seva can be mingled together, blended together. We have tech for seva. Like that we have started many such organizations. We have a global Indian scientist forum, GIST. So, like that, 12 streams and nearly all the state units with the university centers and local units, we have, you know, we are the largest scientific organization with the longest chain of units across the country. We have units in the Middle East countries, also all the 7 Middle East countries, we have Science India Forum, in the name of Science India Forum, we have one. These are a small information which we have got last meeting given. These are the certain information, but we are a long organization, big organization, large organization. We are growing. We have nearly 6,000 scientists across the country are working voluntarily for this organization. There are more than 100 universities. We have the representation. And our organization consists of scientists, technocrats, academicians, students, professionals, and common people, those who have passion towards science. All of these people can join in Vijnan Bharati and voluntarily they can work for this nation. Thank you.
And we are extremely happy that the state of Goa has given such exemplary support to this event, without which it would not have been possible. The Chief Secretary of the State, Sri K.K. Sharmaji, thank you so much. Thank you so much, because we could have never done this without the support of state. And this has been our experience. Also, as Ajay Kumarji explained, when the idea of BVS began in 2007, what a role Honorable Chief Minister of MP and the entire government played in making it a great success. What happens to the state, I will explain later. Bhopal, successfully followed by Indore, and the state of Punjab, Jalandhar, and now in Goa, we are. The university has been playing. Universities have been playing very important role. Whenever the BVS takes place, set of universities or the university, here there is one university, Goa University. So we really thank the Vice Chancellor, Sri Satish Shetty, who has really taken the responsibility of really mentoring this event. We have several distinguished people who are blessed, who have been blessing this event right from the beginning. I particularly like to thank Honorable Manmohanji, Dr. Manmohanji, himself is a scientist, who have been guiding and mentoring this event right from its beginning. Professor Shankar Rao Tattwadiji, who is here, who is the left. Always, like a wise man, like a rishi, has been present and guiding us very subtly and sublimely. We have Prabhakar Kunteji, who have founded this organization, who is one of the founders of this organization. There are several distinguished elders who have been involved, who have been guiding. Jay Kumarji mentioned the name of Professor K.I. Vasu, who was the founder of this very idea. So we pay respects to all these elders who are with us. Jay Kumarji has first explained the word. What is Vigyan Bharati? How did the idea emerge? What is the relevance of this idea? What is the far-reaching vision of this organization? How it has spanned across almost entire India, its 33 branch units, its so many verticals, now 14. It is spanning across like a tree, like a banyan tree. And you are invited to join this event actively. I think we must, when the idea came of Goa should be the venue of this, the next event, one person who needs to be credited with this idea is our own Jayantrao Ji, Sastra Buddhi, and let's give a big hand to him. Really. Then you can take it there. It's a small scale. And there is always a challenge in organizing such a massive event in science and technology. And all the people who are associated with here, the Professor Godsey, who introduced us, who welcomed us, Professor Harilal Menon. I will not take all the names, there are several people who got plunged, immersed into this event. One thing happens is when we can have to organize such sandalas in that, it is not restricted to one body. Normally, the science and technology in particular field is really piloted by the body which organizes that event. Not here. First time, wherever we went, as I mentioned, the state government, getting state government actively involved in the whole process, that is our objective. State government must get actively engaged in the promotion of science and technology itself. State government, the university, the national laboratories, the institutions there, all work together under one umbrella. I think that is one contribution of BVS and Vigyan Bharati. And I really thank all the bodies, all the people who have worked tirelessly to make this event happen, and you saw what a tremendous response in Evo. I was not there for the exposition yesterday when the exposition was inaugurated by Honorable Governor. I was just brief about this event, and which I thought Satish will explain the issue of happening. I think he was the right person to explain it, to put it before, but he has kept it very sublime. I am told that this is a very large mega event in science and technology from the national perspective, only the international perspective, which is taking place. Inauguration of a large expedition, and which is very important for particularly for the youngsters and the students and the people at large. Where does our science and technology, how does it look like? What is its contribution from the different dimensions of science which we are exploring, which are contributed by the nation at large and the state? I was told that there are 192 stalls, 12 pavilions, thanks to DRDO, ISRO, CSIR, railways, and STPI, and many of them, I will not take all the names. It is very difficult to get all these people together. And they have responded. They have responded. Thanks to our defense minister, particularly, when you are the state CM, and now as the defense minister, that the energy has imparted to this. I mean, one person whom we must really acclaim, I have not mentioned, who has given the very thing to visible, made visible in our own, to Manohar Parikh. Without him, I think this event would not have been possible, and we are really very, very thankful to him for this. As regards the conference now, large numbers of papers at ET Hope. ET Hope response from all over India. I am told that the highlights are going to be, there will be special, four special sessions, seven plenary sessions in this very hall, and it will be 185 oral presentations, which will run, in this, including these six tracks in a small state, in a place like this country, running six parallel tracks is a, I think it's a remarkable thing which you must see. It happens generally for the international conference or the national conference. So, such is the, I think only 1500 registrations and large number of students come. I was so happy to see, and Vivek Maharaji and I think Jendra Villar. This was what here. The young population, young students of India, we are having in the formal education itself 25 crore aspiring learners from primary education to the higher education. Engaging them into science and technology, I think the goal is, this was the goal, because these are the minds who are going to shape the future of India. Friends, we have set up a large infrastructure, science and thanks to the vision of the founding fathers, I must say that we have set up a very large infrastructure in this country of education, of science and technology. Largest chain of CSIR laboratories, the world's largest chain of laboratories, CSIR laboratories, DRDO laboratories, laboratories set up by DAE, laboratories of the in the field of electronics, information technology, which I have witnessed one after another, this CDAC and other units getting started, space program, and it's all associated bridges across the country. DBT, what I said, and we have set up our IITs, which are proud of the ISS now, which have come up, new central universities, state universities. We are world's second largest education infrastructure in this country. So this, we anticipate, we see that now, world's largest, I would not say infrastructure, but the scientists and aspiring learners and scientists like you, engineers, technocrats, medical doctors, agricultural scientists, environmental scientists, and scientists in a different way, very broad way, are going to shape the future of this nation. We were expecting Dr. Harshvardhan. We had Dr. Harshvardhan. And we really are proud that Dr. Harshvardhan is the Minister of Science and Technology. Really, we are proud of him. Because it is the SNT which is going to decide. And it has decided, it has played a decisive role in the development of the country. So, a conference like this is extremely important. Jai Kumar ji has given you the role. What is different about Vigyan Bharati's vision and what is Vigyan Bharati, BVS, Bharati Vigyan's vision? The distinctiveness, the uniqueness about it. It's a very inclusive platform. Science does not happen only in the universities and the research, or in the, only in the research lab. Science occurs. And we have seen this. Science, particularly the innovations, the new ideas, occur everywhere. They happen in kitchen, they happen on the farms, they can happen in the small artisans' workshops. And we recognize that. There are no platform in which a farmer can come, can present his idea. And indeed, our farmers have contributed to India like no scientist or no agricultural industries before. It is our the toil of our farmers, the innovativeness of our farmers. But uncertainties of our monsoons, they are supporting, they are feeding a large population of 125 crores year after year and innovating on the farm. We want to understand from them. I am very happy to say that we had organized four pre-events: biodiversity, science without recognizing the diversity, biodiversity, which we now come up, and we had four forefathers had gone. They told us that it is the richness of diversity. I think if India stands for something, right from the early days, recognition of this great diversity in all forms, including languages, and that's why we welcome all languages in this moment. We had that, and I'm still happy that Gopalak Mela was organized. I think the years come, I'm IIT, we had said this, I think I was not to. That IISc, I said there are laboratories. There are laboratories and laboratories, there are biotech, reactors and reactors. But have you studied the cow as a reactor, a bioreactor, more, much more than that. Have you ever studied that? And our rishis did so much thing, calling cow as the Gopalan, a cow as the Kamadhim, fulfillment of all desires. I'm telling you, I make a declaration here, say that I see this thing happening. Why cow was worshipped? As we explore cow, Gomata, as we explore more and more, from scientific perspective, from deep scientific perspective, I think not only we start understanding science, but tomorrow's agriculture, which is based on this Govi Gyan, I think a lot of movements are taking place across the country. I'm seeing this happening, that will sustain really the population of this one. So Gopalan Melawa was taken, was one of the pre-events, and that's a really highly satisfying thing. Science teachers program, they were great teachers. And science and focus of all branches. Science teachers, which is Homi Bhabha Center, who helped us organizing this. And of course, the new economy which we created through ideas and innovations and competition. And this issue that a very state has to create, nation has to create, the wealth is something, this future is going to be created with new ideas and innovations, and really, we have to really ignite those minds to create new ideas and innovations. I will only say that the world's economy has been created recently. Some of the, how a new idea can create economy can be recognized by idea like Google. I think one example which says to us, this Google is an example that just a search engine, an idea of some researchers can create in enterprise. And there are several follows, need not be that they create economies more than the economies of several countries put together. That is the importance of ideas and innovations. And that's why I think we had this idea and innovation competition in the pre-event, and many people are exhibiting their, I think, their innovations which we'll have. There are so many things which can be said. The Ayurveda Congress, I think Jay Kumarji will realize that we will, I think, will recognize that more than anybody else when the event started in Kochi. Ayurveda is, we're trying to attract attention to this thing. Why Swadeshi is that yoga and Ayurveda. When the world takes up yoga as a thing, and that paradigm it never existed, it was developed on this side by a rishi, and it's not there for India, it's built for entire humanity. Ayurveda is a paradigm for entire humanity, which will be clear now as the years. When this event occurred in, I think we had this event in Delhi, what an event it was. And we never saw that, we will see this day when we have been organized this from Cochin to Pune to Jaipur to Bhopal to, say, Bangalore, Bhopal and Delhi. Ayurveda thing which showed never like ever. National Ayush Mission was launched because of how these events can shape the policies of the government. We wanted to attract towards the Indian indigenous sciences, and that Ayush was defined in the things Ayurveda, Yoga, Siddha, Yunani, and Homeopathy as well. And that nation has been placed as a national mission. I think that is a great deal. How such events can shape the policies of the nation and also of the state. Madhya Pradesh, sir, Sharmaji will trace an example that when we define that science and technology important for the state, it is not only the responsibility of the central laboratories, Department of Science and Technology and other departments, scientific departments. A similar event should occur in the state, similar structure to receive that, to receive the contribution of the great things which are happening. Who is to receive? The state has to receive this. And for a collective of districts, for a collective of block level, for a collective of village levels, and see the application. There is not the fundamental or any, but relevant problems, like for example, how remote sensing can help the resource mapping. That has to be done, job has to be done by the state. What are the priorities of the state and what challenges can be take place? I think we want like this interface to take place. That these are the things which are relevant to state, or we orient, or we fund, or we catalyze in our universities, in our colleges, in our policies, the science and technology. If this is not recognized by the state, I think we don't understand. Information technology may take place across the world, but what is my relevant to me? Now I will just give one example of EVM, electronic voting machine. A small level, I think it was done in Trivandrum, in my lab in the book, one of the earliest models. And we never recognized that this will have such an impact. And a small innovation like EVM, there was this, one of the world's first innovation of that kind, at that cost. And then, of course, it's carrying it through across the thing to the general elections and the state election. First experiment was done by Kerala Municipal Corporation. And then, what impact that no nation can really conduct a democratic election, democratic processes, without, I think, the way we have done and the world has run the list. I'm just giving an example of that kind of thing. What role the state can play? The state has been given that federated role. It is Vigyan Bharati structure. It should be a federated structure. We recognize right from the beginning. It will be a federated structure. It must reach out to Pranthivis. It will have many, many things, like I said, 12, 14 teams on which it will work. Federated structure is important for us. So that's why this is for us, for this, and the state has taken like this. Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. Waste management, I think you know my Jaykumar, you talking about waste management. I was thinking, can we handle that? So it's difficult. Like waste management, we said, we'll set up a waste management institute in Bhopal. Maybe small way. No, we don't. Swachh Bharat. We looked at this, linking our institution, the scientific laboratory, to villages directly. Or we have been occupied with the things with that the development has taken place in the US, in Japan, in this one. And when Mr. Jitendra Singh became the science and technology minister, he brought to memory, all your scientists want to go, always out, all directors want to travel to California, to somewhere, and to France, to solve problems of India. They want to go out and since always, most of the time they are out. How do you do that? Is everybody traveling to Jammu and Kashmir? Everybody traveling to villages, their own villages, and sing? And we propose that there should be Unnat Bharat Abhiyan, linking our national laboratories directly to the villages. Take the responsibility directly. I have to do this. I will end with this one. We have many challenges before us. As the Vigyan Bharati and Dr. Karkoshkar was discussing with me also, and I know these issues are. We have to make choices now. In science and technology policies or what do we do? Where do we focus on? We are large cities. World's largest cities are national geographic world. Largest cities will be in India. World, China and India. Large. Delhi is already the second largest city of the world. And these large cities have largest slums of the world. 40% population. Are you working there? Are you walking through the slums? Have you ever walked? Our scientists, myself, so take for seven. Yes, walk through the, what are their problems? Start working with them, understand them. Large cities, smart cities, and slums. Simultaneously, issues are being addressed. Whether it's going to be an intensive agriculture based on biotechnology or geofoods, or we are going to focus on natural agriculture, cow-based agriculture, cow science-based agriculture, and what are the things to do? Whether we have large dams, the linking of the rivers, or we manage to directly on the farm. Every drop will be saved in the air itself. There are so many choices. Nuclear energy or alternative energies. I think these are the problems Vigyan Bharati should be seized with. And we have. We are also. We are learning. I must say that no, we might have taken a position. We want to be open. We want to create an open platform in which the stakeholder, the farmer also should have opinion. People should have. We should express that. Listen to openly. All issues will not be clear. We will not know, we will find it very attractive now, but it has long-term effects in the decades or centuries to come. I think we want to create that kind of platform. We wish to have that kind of platform. We may be wrong. We will correct ourselves. We should be. There will be opinions. But it should be, I would say that it should be open platform. We would like to be open platform. Listen to all the sides. And that's why Vigyan Bharati has been organizing such issues and debating such issues before the people. Whether the nuclear power should be like this or not. Should we understand? We should be understand. Try to understand. Finally, I would say that this is an inclusive platform. And therefore, as you mentioned about the glorious heritage of this country, this was taken in science complex. We don't teach. We are not proud. We are not aware, as I said. We are not aware that Pythagoras theorem came in the form of Shukla Sutras. In while constructing the Vedas in the Yajnas, and what a contribution has been. And Pythagoras has new representations of this one. So there are many issues I am not making, because there are sessions which are taking place throughout this. I think one of the highlights of this conference is going to be, this is going to be a thing throughout the thing is conference. All the 3 days we are going to have this, and it will be a great treat to listen to that, which we want to bring the dimension. Lastly, we looked at science and physical and material, at biological or life level, at information and cognitive level, environment, at entire earth, associated social issues, and as you said, the spiritual level as well. Though we don't develop, India's greatest contribution is that spirit. Try to understand not only the world, but try to understand the self, which is trying to understand the world. I think the Rishis recognize that. You can't recognize or know everything about everything of the world, and but don't know anything about yourself. That is going to be half knowledge and very dangerous knowledge which you have come to. The 21st century is going to be a dangerous century if you don't do that. That's why you see the emblem, you see the, I think, very rightly designed. There is here a yogi. He's a yogi, he's meditating, contemplating, and he's looking at that thing that represents that. The nuclear model represents this, atomic model which represents that science. Scientific view, but he's also meditating on his own self. Science and spirituality, that's a unified view, which will give the true knowledge, which is one of the long-term views of our Vigyan Bharati and BVS and all these things, multifarious activities, to have full knowledge and give it to the world, not only to ourselves. This Vaishvik, give it to the world and show the direction. When our Prime Minister talks about the India should emerge as the Guru, Vishwa Guru, it is through this entirely this unique view which Rishis have given to us, which Vigyan Bharati and BVS is trying to resurrect or understand. Friends, great, have a great feast of knowledge here, and particularly great number of students who are getting attacked. And that is our great hope. In the 21st century has to survive. That hope will survive us, and India will show the way. And thank you indeed for responding greatly to this conference. So thank you.
Dr. Anil Kakodkar ji, Padam Vibhushan, Dr. Vijay Bhatkar ji, President of the Gyana Bharati, Shri Jay Kumar ji, National Secretary General of Gyana Bharati, Shri Jayanti Shastra Bhuse, National Organizing Secretary, Dr. Shethi, the Vice Chancellor, first of all, I deem it a great privilege for the state of Goa to have been chosen by the Vigyan Bharati for their fourth edition of the Bharatiya Vigyan Sammelan. As we have heard, previous three sammelans were held, two in Madhya Pradesh, one in Punjab, and that they chose to bring the fourth sammelan to Goa, a small state. I would like to thank the president, the national president, and all the members of the organizing committee for this decision. I would also like to mention before the audience that government of Goa, the chief minister, the earlier chief minister, present the defense minister, they agreed to partner with the organizing of this event and become one of the important patrons together with Goa University, and that is how, with the efforts of all the people who have worked, and the support provided by the government, it has become possible to bring Amadeus this very, very unique event. You have all heard from my predecessor, distinguished speakers, the context in which the Vigyan Bharati has been organizing these seminars. Yesterday, the Governor of Goa, Honorable Governor of Goa, inaugurated the exposition again on various scientific developments in the country, beginning from traditional to the modern sciences. What are we exactly looking at? I would like to say that as education has evolved in India in the last 40, 50 years, many of us have continued to pay more attention to only the modern science, the physical sciences, the physics, chemistry, and then many of our youth, when we were also young, we are looking towards going to engineering colleges, IITs, medical colleges, becoming teachers of sciences and others. But somehow or other, we did not get time to reflect on if we are such an old civilization and which has survived amidst all the conflicts in the world, amidst various movements in the world, now for thousands of years, what were those strengths? How were we living? What were we doing in the countryside? What were we doing in the mountains, around the rivers, which has made us what we are? So Vigyan Bharati is bringing that to the fore. It is bringing at the same time what have been the achievements of the Indian scientists, what are the achievements of the Indian brains in the field of modern science itself. So on the one hand, they are giving us a sense of what we can achieve. I think globally for the man and for the humankind and for us, it's important to know what our strengths are. I was in some session and it was being said that you should completely shed off ego. Then somebody said, if you completely shed off ego, then you become as if I am a very inferior person, I am nothing. If you have too much of ego, then you tell another person, you are nothing. So what was mentioned was, what was suggested was a fairly evolved person who was giving the talk on the basis of knowledge of scripture, spirituality, and he said that it's very important for each person to have a healthy sense of ego. So the healthy sense of ego will come from if we take ourselves seriously in a correct manner. And that is where distinguished Dr. Kakorkar, people from the other organizations like the DRDO, Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, we have these national institutions where our Indian men and women have done great work in the field of space, in the field of nuclear energy, in various other fields. So for us from India to recognize that tells us that ministers resides the potential in the college students, in the school students who are going to be the future generation, and that beginning from that, looking at their examples, we will continue to achieve the best in the scientific research. But then as I said, that should we only be concentrating there, or should we also look into how our life has been? If you look at Goa, there have been the mangroves, there have been the fishing communities, there have been the salt pans, there have been our community way of living. At that time, we lived in a very harmonious manner without resorting to the modern analysis of the modern science. And now when we start going into it, we find that communities in the forest, in the villages, they are already practicing the traditional science in one manner or the other. Only thing is that it is not being currently documented, and it's not being currently taught, and it's not being currently recognized. Should we lose this? Not at all. We just heard the eloquent address by the other Bhushan, Dr. Vijay Bhatkarji, and he has brought out how it is necessary and how the organization is working by spreading its presence amongst various states of India, amongst various regions of India, and I think in government of Goa, we would like to take this forward, not only because of the Vigyan Bharati, this current event, which is of course a mega event and it will serve us to rethink and reintegrate, and this will go the message to other states also in the country, that what is it that governments in the field of education and in the way we run the governments, how we should be using science in general and also the traditional strengths that we have, and how we should be integrating them into our society. as it's been said that human living is coming from the rural sites to the cities, and cities have problems of cleanliness, they have problems of how to manage solid waste, sewerages, water supply, and here science becomes important. It's not only important for the government officials and the agencies providing the services, but each person, each citizen, he, she, if he has an idea of how her is living impacts and how she or he lives in the society, and their science, traditional methods, if they can be integrated, we can be better human beings and we can live more happily. The goal of all human beings seems to be, which I personally feel, to live comfortably and to be happy. Now, how do you do that? By consuming too much resources or by thinking appropriately, being a little compassionate towards other people, and all those compassion, living simply or feeling happy while having minimum, they can't come only from our knowledge of physics or knowledge of chemistry, but they come from thought processes which are validated over centuries. Some references have been made by the president and my previous speakers about the spirituality, its relation, how to combine science and spirituality, how to talk about it, how to take it to a young person or an older person. And I think when we little bit immerse ourselves in those thought processes, we can come to believe that it's possible to live happily, and we will be leaving behind and creating a world for our younger people and for the future generations where the world will be a safer place, where the best will be available over millennia and in a sustainable manner. I myself grew in countryside, and at that time we did not conserve so much the allopathic medicine. No discipline is to be derided. The allopathic medicine has gone and expanded in a big way. We all need it. The question is that if there is alternative medicine knowledge, if there is the Ayurveda and some small medicines can cure you, should we necessarily be going to the chemical medicines which have their own various types of side effects? Not all of them, but there are. When the green revolution began in India, a lot of chemical fertilizers were used. In Punjab, which is the granary of India. And now we find that in Punjab, there are a lot of cases of cancer. Is it correlated? The scientists are working on this and finding out solutions. But is it that we need to grow all our crops with the chemical fertilizers, or can we use organic fertilizers? Are there some traditional methods? Today, people have a lot of job opportunities, but then we still have our lands, 1 acre, 2 acre in Goa itself. A lot of people are not cultivating their lands. Assuming if we took interest and cultivated at 1 acre or 1 hectare with traditional ways of cultivating organic, we will get foods and crops which are very healthy. So this is across the country actually. So this this is what we will be learning from this this conference. And I don't want to be speaking too much. We have the keynote address by Dr. Kakorkar coming to all of us in the next few minutes. But I would like to leave this platform by saying that in government of Goa, as far as the schools are concerned, as far as our colleges are concerned, we are committed to supporting further infusion of teaching of science, whether it is the use of information technology to make eventually smart classrooms, popularizing computers, popularizing science, and it has been a great opportunity for us, the holding of the fourth Sammelan in Goa. I'm sure it's going to profit all our young minds in the state. They're going to be really beneficiary of this mega, gigantic science and technology event. As a representative of the state of Goa, I would like to once again thank the Vigyana Bharati for choosing Goa and for coming to us here, bringing all the scientific leaders here. I am also seeing that the Indian prominent scientists who have excelled in science, quite a few of them are associated with Vigyana Bharati, and therefore their way and the way the organization is growing, I feel very nice and very proud. I am happy that I could be here in the midst of all of you today, and thank you for patiently listening to me. Thank you.
Today we have assembled here to witness the inauguration of fourth Bharati Vigyan Sammelan. In this context, let me give you a glimpse of the happenings or activities to be held in the coming 3 days. The main theme of the Sammelan, as you know, is innovation in science and technology in the service of mankind. And this has been divided and grouped into 4 different branches, like Make in India, Swachh Bharat, Modern Medicine and Ayurveda, and Footprint of Indian Science in the Global Scientific Development. This has further been divided into 16 sub-themes. In fact, altogether, we have received around 414 abstracts from 24 states and 2 union territories and 2 from international, that means from Turkey. Among them, 185 abstracts have been accepted for oral presentation and 222 for poster presentation. The oral presentations will be held on 6th, 7th and 8th February, while the poster will be on 7th and 8th. In the coming 3 days, you will witness the plenary speeches by, the first will be by Dr. Satish Kumar, Chief Controller R&D and Distinguished Scientist DRDO, followed by Dr. Rajan, Director of NCAR, then Sri Ashwin Shroff, he is the CMD of Excel Industries, then followed by Padma Bhushan, Dr. Vijay Kumar Saraswat, former DG DRDO and present member of Niti Aayog, followed by that Dr. J.R. Sharma, NRSC representing ISRO, then Dr. S.W. Mankpi, Director of NIO, and the last by Padma Vibhushan, Dr. M.S. Valiathan, he is the former VC of Manipal University and presently he is National Research Professor. We have, in addition to this, we have arranged 4 special sessions. These are, first is M. Giri, that is, will be presented by Dr. Prafulla Kale, Director of M. Giri. M. Giri stands for Mahatma Gandhi Institute for Rural Industrialization. And in the same session, we will have a talk by Dr. P. Bhatt, Prakash Bhatt. He is from SCOPE, Society for Community Participation and Empowerment. And followed by that, we have a session on STPA. STPA stands for Software Technology Parks of India. And this will be convened by Dr. Omkar Rai, DG of STPA. And on the occasion, we have a chief guest, Professor Dinesh Singh, he is a VC of University of Delhi. And the speakers are Sri Sarathi Guhapatra, he is the director of safetycar.com. Sri M.N. Vidyashankar, he is the president of Indian Electronics and Semiconductor Association. Sri Sanjeev Keskar, MD, PMCS Private Limited. And Sri Pradeep Gupta, chairman and MD, Cyber Media. Then Sri Ajay Chaudhary, founder HCL and former chairman HCL Infosystem Limited. Another special session is on India's space program. This is going to be on 7th. It will be presented by Dr. Sharma of National Remote Sensing Center. And then final 4th one is would be chaired by Dr. S.W. Nakpi, and this is going to be on Earth Sciences. Here we have 3 speakers, Dr. Anil Kumar Gupta, of Director, Wadia Institute of Himalayan Geology, followed by Dr. Ramesh, Director of IIGM, Indian Institute of Geomagnetism, and that is followed by Dr. Nigam, Deputy Director of NIO. We have another session in ancient science or traditional activities. The first session is on India's contribution to science and technology, to be chaired by Dr. C.S.R. Prabhu. The second session will be chaired by Dr. Y.L. Nene. The title is India's contribution, same title. And the third is going to be by Dr. P.P. Holley. Hence, in total, we have around 31 sessions to debate and deliberate on the topics of science and technology. And this is in a synopsis about the happenings for the coming 3 days. Finally, let me take this opportunity to wish you all for a fruitful debate and discussion in the 3 days. And I wish you all a comfortable stay and a safe journey back home. Thank you.
I request Professor Suhas Godse, resident Vigyan Bharati, Goa, India, to give.
Respected dignitaries on the dais, off the dais, invitees, students, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the local organizing committee, it is with great pleasure that I welcome you to this fourth Bharatiya Vigyan Sammelan and Expo 2015. The expo was launched yesterday by Honorable Governor of Goa, Srimati Mridula Sinha. We gather in this beautiful Dinanath Mangeshkar Auditorium today for the inaugural session of the Sammelan that is popularly known as BVS 2015. It has been said that science begins when someone asks a question. It picks up momentum when that question gets pursued through the scientific method. The process concludes with creation of new knowledge, new insight, or a new product, or very often just new questions. The traditional venues for conducting this activity has been research labs, universities, academic institutions, and so forth. However, science need not be restricted only to these locations. Science gets done in household environment, in farms, on roads, whenever a question is pursued with the angle of the scientific method. The purpose of BVS 2015 is to provide a platform to showcase the products of this thinking, thinking that goes on everywhere, but which doesn't always find a platform to showcase the product. Traditional scientists do have meetings where they do have such a platform, but the non-traditional activity that goes on does not always find a place where they can showcase what goes on in their minds. BVS 2015 is designed to provide that platform. You will therefore see here the traditional scientists delivering lectures on their science. You will find here technology products that have come out of the laboratories of India, and Expo that is associated with this Sammelan is the main place where you will find these technological products. But you will also find here papers presented on what cannot be found in the traditional journals that are associated with scientific publishing. You will find posters which are written by people who don't work in national laboratories, but nonetheless do science. That is because they follow the method that scientists are taught to follow. That is because they follow the discipline which is associated with the scientific method. Let me therefore once again welcome you to this gathering. We are specially targeting the students of this state to come and participate in this learning experience, which I believe is quite unique for this state. I sincerely hope the high school, the higher secondary school, the colleges will make maximum use of this opportunity to listen to the traditional scientists and the non-traditional scientists to enhance their perspective of what science is. Thank you.